Hey everyone, Mike here, and for the next few videos, you get a short intro, and it's just going to be the same one every time, because the next few episodes had kind of an unfortunate accident. Zay and I recorded these a while ago, and they were specifically recorded right when Phantasy Star Online 2 came out, and me, being the dummy that I am, tried to wipe my computer and make the Windows Store work, so I could play that game. And when we recorded post-wipe, everything looked like it was working in our recording software, but it didn't actually record any game audio. So we have Zay and I talking, but no game audio behind it. We went back and forth on what we were going to kind of do about these episodes, and ultimately just decided we're going to release all these videos bunched up. So for the next few releases, instead of one episode, you're going to get two or three. That's intentional. We cut a lot of dead air where things weren't happening out, but we left in the talking and the jokes. In some places, we've even spliced in sound effects and game audio, and at one point, something that I'm pretty sure is going to get us DMCA'd to spice up the recording. It's only for a couple hours of content, five episodes specifically, and then we're back to having game audio because we caught the mistake and fixed it. Super sorry that it happened. Thank you for sticking with us, everybody that's subscribed and come along for the ride so far. It's just kind of the growing pains of learning what we're doing here. And I think we all learned a valuable lesson, which is to never play Phantasy Star Online 2. All right, let's go for real. The pig is waiting for you in the dissection room, bitch.
Bitch. Yeah, that's, I remember where that is. It's in the basement of the house.
Yeah, I remember this specifically because I thought we were going to have to fight the kid, but we don't have to fight the kid yet because the kid's going to be the final boss. So this is shitty in its own way because it means we're getting closer to having to fight the kid that I don't want to see or look at.
How bad is it going to be if you shoot in the head 100 times, right? I mean, it's one child.
That's a good point. So this here, this here is how we like got through. So I think we go this way and then we'll get downstairs and then we can get to the dissection room.
Do you have a snake key?
No, I don't have a cobra key yet.
Okay. Well, whatever.
That is a wow.
Yeah, man. That's Lucas's place. He's partying. You gotta get in there. You absolutely gotta get into that VIP room, man. It's sick.
I imagine that's a later problem, but I gotta get a closer look at this real fast. Yeah, it's just fucking flat. Oh my god, look at all the shit here. Supplements.
Welcome to paradise, dude. Yeah, I have to kill chaos. Welcome to paradise, dude.
Okay, we were looking to see if I had a cobra key, which I don't think I have. Yeah, no.
The other is this, I don't know, whatever. What supplements do?
Pills.
Oh.
Can't be used as is, make them into medicine first.
What is it? Oh, go to the combine menu? Does it say what you need to combine it? No.
Oh, but it's these, psychosim.
Oh, okay. So you just need to
completely make your own. Okay.
Gotcha. Well, I honestly completely no memory of a supplement item at all, so I'm like, what the hell?
I imagine that before our inventory is full, we'll encounter another storage bin, knock on wood.
Yeah. I mean, there's one even like on the way to the dissection room, but I don't think you need to hit it right now. Ah, back in the nice, peaceful house where nothing bad could ever happen.
Always on the lookout for, like, ammo I miss, now that we know they're fucking everywhere. Just gross slop. Ah!
Dude, it's an old lady in a wheelchair, and you just took a shot at her.
Yeah, she shows up in the worst fucking places.
She can barely even move, and you're shooting her, man. That's so...
Well, she clearly moves well enough that she's making it around this fucking house, okay? She's my, like, warning bell, I think.
Or someone could be moving her since she's in a wheelchair.
I guess that's possible.
Like, the options that you're presenting are either someone moves her, or she has Dragon Ball Z instant transmission and is teleporting across the entire building.
Yeah, and you know what? I think those are equally likely.
I mean, I guess fair enough. Half of the sea. Hey, there's a
What the f-
monster. Look there.
Oh my God.
He's got moves. And now he has no head.
Holy shit. Honestly, old lady was scarier than that.
Yeah, you never know what kind of secrets an old lady is keeping.
I do better with
The
this
mold
is
men.
me kicking myself in the ass later. But yeah, I feel like I do better with there's his body. With weird supernatural bad guys than ghosts or real people. Prove you're a real man, stick your hand down the pig's throat.
Well,
His joints are already stiff. Sickeningly sweet stench. He started to rot already. Yeah, no, hey, no shit. That's just a sign. All right, here we
all
go.
right, get in there. Honestly, it's like that's not even that. Like, it's gross, don't get me wrong, but it's like it's a dead body. What's it gonna do? Stab you? Probably not. Seems unlikely.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Some, I guess there's snake rooms that are somewhere we need to go into.
Yeah, so this door is just gonna let us get out of here faster. Just
Yeah.
chill. That's good.
Is there one on the second floor, maybe?
Yeah, gotta be. Yeah, master
Okay.
bedroom.
There you go.
Yeah, and then I bet one is in the other old house.
I think it might be. I'm trying not to spoil anything, I guess. But I think there's another one in the opposite upstairs where that one is on your map, and you just didn't reveal it. Like you didn't close them to the door or something in the past to like have it marked with
Oh.
the key. Maybe.
You dumb
Just
idiot.
jump, moron. I think I gotta be almost dead. This guy sucks. There you go. One
Well, we have
bullet
one bullet
spare.
left.
You do have a flamethrower with a lot of fuel. Don't forget that.
Yeah.
Oh, poor guy. He just coming out of the wall to immediately be set on fire. That's a good block. I think he's dead. Yeah. There you go.
Fucking riddance, man.
Hey man, I just wanted to have a fun time and fucking set me on fire. Kind of fucked up. Well, I'm sure that nothing bad's gonna happen on your run back up to a familiar area. Oh no. Something bad has happened.
Ow, motherfucking spider guys. The problem with the flamethrower is I can't really see the attack through the flame.
Yeah, he's
You are
dead.
not still
He
alive.
is
Are you
not dead.
fucking
He
kidding
is
me?
alive.
I'm gonna die.
His head blew up, so the
Holy
fire was
shit.
so powerful, his head exploded. Pretty good flamethrower, you gotta admit.
It is good.
At least the maybe not the damage compared to some other flamethrowers in video games, but it's rare fire makes someone's head actually just blow up. Upstairs. I think the kids' room door, it doesn't show on the map right there because I just don't think you got close enough to it, but I think that's a snake lock, I want to say. Could be wrong.
Yeah, I think you're right. I'm expecting we're going to have an encounter with Daddy relatively soon. Oh.
No. He's just a
The
gross looking
fucking
guy.
so the gooby gons are just in it now.
Yeah. Man, they are whiffing some attacks though today. Uh-oh. There you go. Flamethrower was doing some work.
Oh, I thought I maybe got the block off in time. Uh-oh.
You got time. I mean, these guys are morons. There you go. His head blew up. You can hear the sound. Yeah, I guess his arm blew up.
I heard something blow up.
Something blew up. A time order tradition. Letting the player know I'm dead by blowing up my own body part.
Yeah, disgusting, gross blow-up noises. That's a classic. Okay. Prediction is there's going to be shit I don't fucking like in the master bedroom, because this is the master bedroom. This is where daddy and the wife fornicate, you know?
Imagine you go in there and they're just gross blob monsters going at it, though.
Look at her. She's fucking back.
I mean, she had time to get up there. You were fucking around with the inventory and stuff. Ooh. Nice. Something below the... Some more shotgun shells.
Oh, grandmother.
Nice.
Don't mind us. Just, trying to fucking get around you. Hey, oh, secret door.
My shotgun ammo. Bring that back.
Lockpick.
In the other room, looks like.
Yeah, it is in the other room. Nothing else in here except for the secret door that's very obvious.
Hey, don't look at that. You're not supposed to know that's there yet. Good point. You didn't see nothing.
We're getting this shit out just in case there's something behind this door.
Yeah, fair enough. It's a picture. That's pretty scary. Ooh.
Narrow rounds.
I know, so it looks like your cycles just ran out, but oh no, it's still going. Okay. Treasure photo.
It's a head on top of a fucking thing.
Again, do not remember where that is at all. Backpack.
Nice.
That's a good fucking
pickup. You love to get the fucking backpack. Some shit underneath us, it seems like.
Yeah.
Plan for weapon of some sort.
Oh, I think that's just... I think that's showing where the grenade launcher is.
Yeah, that does look like the grenade launcher.
Nothing.
Empty drawer.
It's such a weird game design thing of being like, we need to just make empty drawers you can open for no reason. Wouldn't want you to have an item in it.
Yeah. It sort of feels like they took the same time as all other clocks. Okay, that's how we open the secret door.
Yeah, it's just another clock.
Yeah, it feels like it's like maybe... Like, you used to be able to break barrels in Zelda and shit, and there'd be nothing in them. And they were like, well, we gotta have empty barrels in this game. What's our barrel equivalent? Oh, drawers.
You could open one of every 10 drawers to find nothing.
So it's probably best to go find a clock, hey?
Yeah, find a clock. Now I think about it, I think this game does do a thing where it's like, if you have low ammo or health, it like actually will spawn more. So maybe those drawers would actually... have something in them if you were doing worse.
Like, maybe I should have opened them first before I got all that ammo.
Yeah, whatever. Well, there's a clock right there next to that door.
Yeah.
It's like,
all right, 10:15.
Yeah.
God's time, as it were. Open this.
What? What a horrible... Like, all of the secrets in this house are so stupid.
Yeah.
Like, we have all of these clocks. We broke all of them so that way you could find the time to get into our secret clock. Like, it just... the logic is so dumb.
I'm supposed to wind it this way, I guess. Yeah.
Yeah, it's not a bad idea.
Just, like, I never... You know, like, if you were really... I think we talked about this last time, but if you were trying to, like, actually secure something, just, like, get a fucking bike lock. You know?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I can't break through? A bike lock.
Imagine how dumb the puzzle you need to solve to get through a normal lock would be.
Yeah, you gotta find the fucking key.
That's impossible.
There's a reason the snake doors are the most, like, secure things in this house.
Yeah, because the cop had swallowed the key a few days earlier.
Yeah. Fed it to him as a secret. This is a gross room.
That looks pretty cool.
Ethan agrees.
nothing. There you go. One of the two.
I honestly expected that that would be a trigger, and that as soon as we picked it up, we were going to get fucking...
monsters attack. Where are you? Look at the map real quick. Oh, so you're back in the basement. Okay. And I guess the workshop, they're making horse leg wheels. Pretty cool. Pretty cool thing to make in your workshop, I guess.
Okay, so we're in the basement. I don't think we can actually even go back up the way we came.
No, yeah. I think you need like a little drop down.
Because the bed is locked. Yeah. Or the bed came back up. Oh, the bed.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, it did.
So I think we're just going straight. And then right.
Hang a right.
And then out.
Hang a rary.
A rary, as it were.
I feel like, honestly, that was where the Trevor or whatever, remember him?
Oh, yes.
The most powerful old man of all time lived. I think there might be an enemy on the other side of that door.
I think there is.
Well, I mean, you got a shotgun, though. You're powerful, though.
What is this music?
It is crescendoing like crazy, and I don't know why. Honestly, you should hit that door probably and get out of the basement. Did he close the door on you? What the fuck is happening?
Yeah, it like...
All right, well, you're probably fine. There he is. Ooh. That was a good one.
Yeah, that was a good head explosion.
All right.
Well, that was some extreme music.
Defeated the horrible crescendo. I want to throw a save in real quick.
Yeah, I'm feeling that too. I feel like this is like a main floor pop. Like we pop it down here. Because there was stuff under the master bedroom.
Yeah, I think that's probably a good idea. I want to say, like, I think you killed enemies here. So they should be gone. So I think you're safe.
Yeah, I think we're, pop it we're good.
And find nothing outside. A bunch of outside. I might as well go out there and slurp it up. Oh. That fucker did not have a chance.
Yeah. No.
He
gone.
He barked and his head was gone.
Fucking dialed in.
What?
So was swapping to the. I want to keep the bad ammo in here first.
Yeah.
Because I think the good ammo I want to save for when I'm out of shotgun shots.
Yeah. I mean, clearly that enhanced handgun ammo is pretty good based off of instantly deleting that guy outside.
Yes. This is the kids' room.
Yes. Doing great.
I'm not touching the piano.
Touch the piano, come on. It'll be cool.
The kid hates when you touch their piano. April, mommy took me to the hospital in town. They took a photo of my head with a weird machine. Then mommy bought me a 259-piece puzzle from the toy store. April, stupid Oliver keeps teasing me. You're a crazy head. April, I lied to Oliver. I told him to come over for my birthday party, then shut him in the attic from outside by remote control. He kept crying, "Let me out, Lucas." Oh, this is not the scary girl. This is
Lucas
as a child.
Child room.
I changed the remote so stupid Zoe can't go into the attic. I melded it with one of my inventor's contest trophies. Now she'll never find it. Okay.
This MF and inventor, dude.
Yeah, so we're looking
for a melded trophy.
This is just a regular ass baseball trophy. Honorable mention, amateur robotics comp championship.
I'm gonna be honest, I immediately forgot which trophy it was. It was
second inventor's trophy.
Inventors, okay.
Second place, third junior engineering contest. All these are sort of inventor types.
Yeah.
But I imagine it's gonna say inventor trophy.
Yeah.
And shotgun shells.
And a weird cursed soccer ball. Who the fuck goes to the store and says, yeah, give me one of your most cursed soccer balls, please. I need that MF to be downright evil, please. It looks right.
Boom. Yeah, that was like a trophy looking lamp. That makes sense. Some silverware.
Yeah. In all any good child's room.
Yeah, for when they eat their food in there. Oliver stopped his yelling, but sometimes I hear knocking from above. It really stinks and some weird juices dripping from the ceiling. Anyway, since I had time, I changed the remote control trophy again. Now it'll be shiny even at night. Oh, so it would have told us it was the lamp. That's funny.
That makes no sense. He says, come over for my birthday party, locks him in the ceiling. So, like, what? He has no parents? Like, how? Like, yeah, no one looked for him at the one space he said he went to?
We don't know. He just disappeared. Sorry about it.
I guess, but, like, you would think they would have checked the house of the... I don't know.
Maybe he comes from a family with multiple children, such that they didn't really care if they lost one.
Yeah, that's a good point. It's always good to have a few spares and backup, just in case.
Yeah, that's why you have so many.
Maybe run back to the item box.
Is there one up here?
I don't think so. There's a back at the near the stairs to the outside, or like back near the downstairs stairs, or just go outside to the van, maybe, or do that. That works. That's like Jack's birthday.
That's perfectly worth it, in my opinion.
Now just pray you don't find
other things that I'm probably gonna need. Yeah. Renovation contract. Customer Jack Baker. Contractor Trevor and Chamberlain Construction. Okay, so that's Trevor. November 10th, 1992 to November 30th, 1992. Two?
That was the...
Details. Installation of shadow-activated doorway in main hall. Shadow-activated... Oh.
It's so stupid. It doesn't make any sense. Like, what do you mean they installed a shadow-operated fucking lock? It makes no sense.
Yeah, it's dumb.
Just go back to the item box.
Yeah, because
you're gonna want that other crap too, and then you're gonna go to another room.
Yeah. Hey. There's a little doll.
If only you had used your one bullet.
Yeah. Fuck. Hey. Well. You know what? We'll come back for no. Compelling gameplay. I'll come back for that guy. We'll play the happy birthday tape.
And then grab the coins out too. You can buy a whatever. Oh, yeah,
good call.
I think.
Shiny new treat.
Hopefully I didn't lie, but I think you can buy a thing for 5.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Stabilizer. It's the last thing to buy before we get the magnum. So.
Yeah. Does it say what the sailor does right beneath it? It's really hard to see with under the bars. No.
Reload speed.
Okay. Yeah, you want that's a good upgrade.
Yeah. Especially in boss fights and shit like that.
Yeah. Boom. I'll just stick bizarre chemicals into my arm. Nothing bad could ever happen.
Check on Bobby real quick. Still doing great.
He's doing great. He's loving life in there, man.
Yeah. He's a real cool head.
Cooler heads prevail. Oh, these are usually playable, aren't they?
Yeah.
Was Clancy Jarvis the cameraman from earlier?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah, I think so too.
Honestly, I was racking my brain trying to remember, like, what, whose name is that? Why did you say that? It must have been on screen that was paying attention.
Yeah, it seemed
okay
familiar.
Yeah, I think you're right. I'm pretty sure you're right. You have some fun.
Oh.
You're gonna have some fun, dude? Get a candle?
That is horrifying.
I honestly was not paying any attention to what Lucas was saying. Do you have any direction on what you're supposed to do right now?
Just, we're playing a game.
Okay. Games are fun. I like to play games.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Gas leak. It's good.
Seems safe. Okay, several candles.
Oh. Something has begun to happen.
I'm calling the game. I'd really like to make it out of this room alive and not die a horrible, painful death.
It's a fun game.
It's a temp title. Take a candle, light it, and put it on the cake. Fuck you.
Oh boy.
That's a puzzle.
Yeah. I like this whole thing is kind of like a bizarro escape room, and I like genuinely no recollection of what you're supposed to do.
Nope, not that. So I got a candle. It says happy fucking birthday, got a light. You need to put a lit candle in the cake.
Lit candle.
So I gotta light this candle.
Turn off that drip, I guess, so you get not, or like the sprinkler. It's like that's, it's gotta be what that lever was to the right, right?
Yeah, to turn off the sprinkler. This is a puzzle. It's got some weird shapes on it. One of them seems like it's this. Like this like shape here on the wall. Kind of looks like
maybe
one of those.
We've got here. Oh, so that must be the, that's the crank for the turn off the water, right?
Yeah. Gotta be.
Door. Guess you need to cut the rope.
Wonder if this will. Okay, so that is how we light
the candle.
The candle.
And nothing.
Yeah, that's nothing.
Oh.
That's a
great.
Oh. You know what?
I would,
guy. Ethan has had to deal with so much worse than this dude.
See, I was gonna say the opposite. I would way rather reach into a guy's neck than into a nasty, dirty toilet.
Okay. Fair.
See, he puts the thing in his hand. You got a, what'd you get, a telescope?
A telescope, and it told me to use tab.
Oh, can you
use it? Yep.
Put it ready. In your hand. Can you put it in your hand to, like, put it under the water going into the cake room?
Oh, that's a good idea.
Clean it, you think?
Call. Spectacular call.
So that helps in some way.
Yeah, now we have a telescope. This guy, I think, is going to draw something. He's going to draw some symbols.
if we can get him something to draw with, because you got to put something in his hand. This is nothing. This is nonsense.
Yeah. Look at the TVs. Is there anything on the TV? It's like a cool party. And the dog.
Oh. Grandma, scary clown, dog, mom, daddy.
Okay.
Wondering, like, maybe if we... Seems to have been fitted with a polarizing filter. There we go.
Oh.
Handing man.
Bell.
Tower. Little Voldemort.
Okay.
So we go in here.
So you're looking for hanging? Noose?
Yeah. We want this guy. Bell. We want weird. That thing? Yeah. And then Voldemort.
I don't know how you're saying that's a little Voldemort when it's a horrid little baby, but...
That's what little Voldemort looks like.
I think that's what most baby children look like, but hey, you know?
I guess that's true. Okay, so that's not for him, it turns out.
You can burn that on the stove. I remember that one thing for sure. Burn that fucking little doll.
Get this guy in here?
Yeah. Yeah.
Dummy finger. Okay.
Well, I guess he is missing a finger. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't realize. Now he can grab stuff. We don't have anything he can take, though.
Can you wind him up? Does it not do anything even with the finger?
Oh, good point.
No, okay.
No, yeah, I think he's still missing...
Yeah, something to hold on to.
Yeah, he needs something to grab. What haven't we used yet? We haven't done anything with this yet. This is all nonsense. We can't cut the rope because that's the final thing we're going to have to do.
I remember what you need to do next. Do you want me to just tell you?
Crank. Give me one sec and then we'll say okay. Yes. I'm just gonna come back in here and see. No, that's a weird thing. That's the crank thing. We need to turn off the water.
It won't stop coming out. Oh god! It won't stop coming out.
Gross. Okay. What am I doing here now?
Light the candle and you can use it to burn the rope.
Oh.
Yeah. Although, honestly, I kind of question that puny little candle being able to burn a rope, but hey, you know, video game logic.
Post. Also means, interestingly, we probably could have started with that, you know?
Yeah. So the padlock on the door. Loot. How suspicious, a balloon in the balloon room.
Hmm. So that just says happy, so we're gonna need a code.
Yeah. So you got a balloon.
Eventually.
Yeah. What? Dude, that balloon is fucking evil.
Yeah. Oh. Finally something happens. Oh. That's gross. I'm glad something happened to his hand, though. Now he matches our protagonist.
That makes no sense. How would a balloon filled with stuff launch? It's nonsense.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. They were also, like, spiky right away.
Yeah.
Oh, Zay, I hate clowns.
I don't think anyone likes clowns. Oh.
Loser.
I love how dumb that is. because you can wind up that clown 100 times and it won't grab you until it has
it never does in its that. Hand. Yeah, it's gotta have the other hand occupied. I wonder if when you speedrun this game, if you don't have to do any of that other shit, you just go straight to this part.
You never even need to watch this tape, so that'd probably save you a lot of time.
That's a that's a great point. All right, that adds up.
There you go.
Valve handle. All right, we're cruising.
Turn off the water, light your candle again. You're out of this joint. Lucas, I've completed your movie. I watched it so successfully.
He should give me a treat for doing that, I think.
I don't see why he shouldn't. I'm in total agreeance. Another herb to add to the stash.
Yeah, one more herb.
Okay.
This is a creepy fucking version of Happy Birthday. Also, really funny to tell that they couldn't license, like, they didn't pay for the license to the Happy Birthday song, so they had to make one up.
Bro, shitty birthday cake.
This I saw coming from the jump.
Yeah, because there was no way.
The oil was coming out and wouldn't stop coming out.
Relatable.
Oh. Oh. Oh wow, you really do just fucking burn alive, hey?
Yeah.
Oh. That's gross.
Lucas is getting friggin' pumped up about it, dude. He loves it.
Am I still alive? Oh no, it's just the camera. Okay.
Just the camera.
I was like, there's no way. This guy has to be dead.
Hey, Lucas, I don't want to be too critical, but your birthday party fucking sucked, dude.
Fucking sucked.
This guy's got a thing with horrible birthday murders. He's all about
it. I wonder if it's his birthday right now. I started saying that as a joke, but what if it's his birthday right now?
I mean, he's having a party and he did invite you, so, you know, you might be onto something.
Seems like it could be his birthday. Okay, we got 7 inventory slots.
You could go throw that key card in too, actually. I was just thought. No, not in the vault, like in the key door.
Oh, and it'll just like sit there? Okay, yeah. That's good to know.
For some reason, I assumed you floated the idea that it might not, and I'm hoping that I'm right. Yeah.
I hadn't even considered that. I just assumed you had to use them both at the same time, but that's great, obviously. Have we been down here?
I don't know.
Herb.
Another herb. And some sort of...
Gunpowder.
Gunpowder, okay. Oh, there you go. Some stuff.